Good morning. I am Theodore Roosevelt. I would like to read from a book that I wrote in 1916 entitled The Key to Success in Life. There are many qualities which we need in order to gain success, but the three above all, for the lack of which no brilliancy and no genius can atone, are courage, honesty, and common sense. No one quality or virtue is enough. Vigor, honesty, sound judgment, all are needed in order to succeed. The practical man is merely rendered more hurtful by his practical ability if he employs it wrongly, whether from ignorance or from lack of morality. While the doctrinaire, the man of mere theories, whether written or spoken, is useless if he cannot also act. To win success in the business world, to become a first-class mechanic, a successful farmer, an able lawyer, or a doctor, means that the man must devote his best energy and power through long years to the achievement of his ends. There never has been devised, and there never will be devised, any law which will enable a man to succeed save by the exercise of those qualities, which have always been the prerequisite for success. The qualities of hard work, of keen intelligence, of unflinching will. Each man will find that the chief factor in determining his success or failure in life is the sum of his own individual qualities. In the last resort, the man who wins now will be the man who has won always, the man who can win for himself. Do not make the mistake of thinking that it is possible ever to call in any outside force to take the place of a man's own individual initiative, a man's individual capacity to do work worth doing. It is only through labor and painful effort, by grim energy and resolute courage, that we move on to better things. Therefore, I ask of you, the straightforward, earnest performance of duty in all the little things that come up day by day in business, in domestic life, in every way. And then, when the opportunity comes, if you have been successful with the lesser things, I know you will rise to the level of the heroic deeds.